for part two of Embracing the Call and Experiencing. Today's session, we'll be talking about how we can experience peace, the peace that God gives us. Just saying those words, that word brings peace. When I think of peace, I find myself in Mercer, Wisconsin, surrounded by God's nature. As a child, a teen, even now, when I go to my family cabin in Mercer, I stand at the top of the hill, looking down at the lake. And I find myself closing my eyes and listening to the leaves blowing and the trees and the water hitting the shore, and what a feeling of peace I experience. In college, sitting in class, overwhelmed with school, basketball, work, just the chaos of being an 18-year-old college student, I would close my eyes for a moment and picture standing in my spot. It sounds kind of silly when I say it out loud, so don't tell anyone. But you know what? That brought me peace. It reminded me that God is always near me. He goes before me, and He is with me. Now when I stand in my spot, I usually hear little but loud voices playing. But even that brings me peace because I think of God's blessings in my life. Travel back with me now 2,000 years in a time with very little peace. There was a young woman named Mary who found herself in the midst of chaos and uncertainty. If anyone had reason during that time to be a person who experienced little peace, it was Mary. Think about the word peace. Oftentimes we hear calm, harmony, agreement, stillness, quiet, maybe to describe peace. Those words would not describe Mary, or would they? Let's look at Luke chapter 1, starting with verse 26. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age. She who was said to have unable to conceive is now in her sixth month. For no word from God will ever fail." "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word to me be fulfilled." Then the angel left her. Wow, what an encounter with an angel. Here's Mary, who from a very poor family living in Nazareth. Mary was a humble young girl, pledged to be married to Joseph, standing in front of an angel of the Lord. This angel, Gabriel, is telling her the most incredible and terrifying news. She would give birth to Jesus, the Messiah who would save her people. In that moment, God was calling her to be the mother of a precious baby boy named Jesus, who would, in 33 years from that moment, give his life for her and for us. If you received such shocking news, what would have been your reaction? We see how she answers the call in verse 29. Mary was greatly troubled at this greeting, but she was not troubled for long. After humbly asking, "How can this be?" which was a question proposed much different than the question Zechariah asked the angel, she answers the call in verse 38, saying, "I am the Lord's servant. May your word to me be fulfilled." The angel left her. In a moment of a radical life change, she experienced peace. In the struggles to come, such as telling her parents, she experienced peace. Explaining to her attendant that she was carrying God's child, she experienced peace. Traveling to Bethlehem, while very heavy with child, bringing Jesus into the world in a barn, she experienced peace. And the list goes on. In the midst of great chaos, Mary found peace in God. We hear peace in Mary's song. In verse 46 we read, "And Mary said, My soul glorifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has been mindful of the humble state of his servant. From now on all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me. Holy is his name. His mercy extends to those who fear him. From generation to generation, he has performed mighty deeds with his arm. He has scattered those who are proud in their inmost thoughts. He has brought down rulers from their thrones, but has lifted up the humble. He has filled the hungry with good things, but has sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel, remembering to be merciful to Abraham and to his descendants forever, just as he promised our ancestors." Do you hear? Do you hear the peace that Mary has in her song? The only way that Mary could have endured what God was calling her to do was if God went before her and he was with her. She proclaims the promise that God has given to her. When we live in obedience to his calling, we have the peace that he gives. We have the peace of salvation in Jesus, and we have the peace in embracing his call on our lives in the midst of chaos and uncertainty. Not only did he call Mary to play a key role in the Christmas story, his call brought Mary a peace that she had never experienced before. She had a peace of salvation for her people. She had a new song in her heart that would carry her through this chaotic world. God had called Mary to be the mother of the one who would sacrifice all for us. So what is God calling you to do today? Are you embracing peace in your calling? Are you experiencing his peace in your life? As we close, I want to encourage you to take some time to discuss as a group this material. Let me close with this passage of scripture from the words of Paul in Colossians 3. Colossians 3:15, "Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body, you are called to peace. And be thankful. The message Christ dwelled among you richly as you teach and admonish one another with all the wisdom through psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit, singing to God with gratitude in your hearts. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him." Let's be people who can experience peace.